plasterboarding is something immediately addictive. I kind of was addicted to it the minute I saw it. Artist based here in New York City. I work primarily out of blown glass, cast glass, and hand-carved glass to make my one-of-a-kind sculptures, as well as various lines of lighting and other products. I got my start in the arts very early in my life. I like to tell people I've been working in glass for more than half my life because I was lucky enough to be exposed to it when I was 15 at a summer arts program. I kind of was addicted to it the minute I saw it. I went on to study it in college while I was a student at Brown University. I took courses at the Rhode Island School of Design and Glass, but I mainly learned the tradition of glassmaking the old-fashioned way, by apprenticing. You never see glass artists working alone. It's too complex an activity to do by yourself. It's always done in a team environment. This is one of the many, many things we've learned from the Italian tradition of glass making that's been passed on to the American artists over the last few decades. But that said, you know, I work with the same crew of artists, and there is a kind of a shared sensibility to the glass blowing team when you've been working with a crew. You all know how to explore together, you all know the problems that can evolve in a production and a technique. You all kind of tackle the issues together. It's a constant source of great joy. And I think you can see that. And my work is really so much about purity, purity of color, purity of line. And in that sense, quality is really very, very important to me. I'm a very harsh critic of some of the natural marks and evolutions that can come out of the glass-making process that just don't fit the purity of my idea that I want. A lot of times I'll throw pieces away because the quality isn't right. A lot of times I'll spend days carving away tiny little details that most people wouldn't see, but to my eye, it affects the quality. So quality is very, very strong in my work, and it's very, very important to my overall design. I draw my inspiration, I'd say, from two sources. One, from outside of my work. A lot of the 20th century modernist paintings, people like Rothko, Nolan, Kelly, Pollock to some extent, all those New York modernists. Their sensibility in terms of using color as kind of emotional gesture. I think being an artist is really just about experimentation, constant experimentation, having a critical eye towards what you do. I'm never happy about my work. I'm always constantly my most severe critic, and I think that's part of the nature of being an artist is constantly editing and exploring and creating. I am Jamie Harris. I'm a glass blower and glass artist here in New York City. I am Paper Brown Bag. I show my work at various fine art galleries, R. Duane Reade Gallery in St. Louis, Vetri and Traver Gallery in Seattle and Tacoma, Washington, Hismo Gallery in Colorado. I also do a line of exclusive design pieces that are shown right now at Barney's New York, here in New York. I guess what I'm working on right now, I'm working on a new series of my new cast glass sculptures called my infusion block sculptures that I'll be showing at a show called Glass Weekend which is held at Wheaton Arts in Millville, New Jersey over the summer. It's in early June, and it's a really wonderful exhibition of really the top glass galleries in the country.
Talk about tomorrow.